Hey lovelies, it's Kate. Welcome back to another video. It's finally time for The Sims 4 Tiny Living. The pack is finally out, so of course I had to build a tiny home. I built this on a 40x40 lot in Brindleton Bay, and 40x40 sounds super big for a tiny build, but as I've learned, lot size doesn't matter. It's all about the size of the tiny build itself, so you can even build on a 64x64 lot and you can do some fun landscaping as long as your build is tiny. So I decided to build on a 40x40 lot because, I mean, the build is tiny and it's in the center and I wanted to do some landscaping, but at first I tried to build on a 50x50 lot and the lot size was just overwhelming for me. And I never thought that I would ever say this, but in relation to the build size, it was just too much space for the landscaping, at least for what I had planned. Of course, you could totally do that. It just depends on what you are going for and what you want to build. So I had no idea what I was going for. I just knew that I would like to use the terrain a little bit, that I would like to have a little pond and a little deck, and I totally underestimated how tiny actually is when it comes to the tiles. So in the tiny living enthusiast community, because a lot of people love tiny builds in The Sims 4, the build itself is supposed to be super tiny. Like, some people build a 2x2 tiny home, for example, which is super small, and I was kind of going for a really small build. Like, I really wanted to build something that's truly tiny, and I ended up building a 5x3 build. So the build itself has 15 tiles. And I consider that to be proper tiny, at least for what I'm used to, but I also wanted to use a couple of tiles on the outside. Like, I wanted to create this deck and a patio, and there are different tiers in this game, and the tiny tier has up to 64 tiles, and this is not a lot at all. So I was okay with building a proper tiny home, but I definitely wanted to use some foundation on the outside to make it look extra special and all that, but I couldn't really do that. So I ended up using 63 tiles, and this is still in the tiny tier. There are three tiers in total. One is micro, one is tiny, and one is small, and I really wanted to build a proper tiny home. And when it comes to the tiny living community, I mean, those people who build tiny houses all the time, and those of you who really enjoy tiny builds, those people would never consider 64 tiles to be tiny. So when you're using up all these 64 tiles, then this should probably really include a patio or something, just some other stuff, but the build itself should be a little bit smaller, at least from what I've read on Twitter. And I don't know, I'm not a tiny build expert, you guys know this, but if you are really using those 64 tiles for just the build, just for the living area, it's probably not really considered to be proper tiny by those who really enjoy tiny builds. It's just crazy what I've seen on Twitter during the last days. I was just blown away. For me, it's just something that's so new. I mean, I've tried to build a couple of tiny builds in the past. I now know that these weren't really proper tiny. And I also know that there are just impossible things that are actually possible. Samaki, for example, but a 2x2 tiny home, completely functional, just 2x2, just think about this, 4 tiles. And she also came up with a little trick to build a completely functional bathroom on only 1 tile. And I used her method. I recreated the bathroom that she created. She shared this on Twitter and she kind of broke the Sims community with her tweet, and everyone was so blown away. And she figured out which objects to use and how to place them to have a fully functional 1 tile bathroom. And this way you can save a lot of space and you can just squeeze in a 1 tile bathroom into your tiny build, especially if you want to build a proper micro home. No matter if micro, meaning what tiny build enthusiasts consider to be tiny, or just micro by what the game tells you is micro in the micro tier, you can just squeeze in a amazing bathroom. And I'm going to link her Twitter post down below in the description box. I mean, you can see here how to build it, but of course I want to give her proper credit in there. In her original tweet, you can see how she created this wonderful bathroom. It's just amazing. You need Discovery University for this though, because there is this wall shower in Discovery University, and this is kind of part of the trick that you place your shower above the sink and then it's functional. So at first I tried to recreate this with a different toilet and sink, and then it wasn't working. I'm not really sure if it might work with other objects as well, but then I ended up using exactly the objects that she used in her bathroom. And you have to make sure that you use the move objects cheat. And when you press Alt on your keyboard, you can move objects freely and they don't snap to the grid. And you have to move the toilet a little bit into the wall. And you also have to push the sink a little bit into the wall. And then you place your shower above. I figured this out by looking at her bathroom, and when you look at the bottom there is a drain, the shower drain, and when you just look at the distance between the shower drain and the sink in her original bathroom, then you just get an idea how far you really have to push your sink into the wall, and then you just have to let your sim try to use all three objects, and then when it works, it works. If not, you just have to kind of tinker with it a little bit. You have to move the toilet a bit to the left and more into the wall and all that. You just kind of have to find the perfect spot, but it totally works. It's totally functional and it's just amazing. So I'm going to link Samaki's Twitch channel and her tweet down below in the description box. Please make sure to check her out. She's just amazing. She's a wonderful streamer, a lovely, wonderful person. She's the sweetest person ever. She's very talented. And in case you don't know her yet, but I'm sure that most of you know about her, you will definitely not regret checking her out. So about this build, it ended up being quite modern, I would say. I used the Spotty wall color for the exterior and also for part of the interior. This sounds as if there's a super big interior, part of the interior. It's just one room, but I used the wall color in the kitchen area. There's not really a kitchen area in a tiny build, but just behind the counter, I guess you could say. So here I'm using a debug object. I ended up using multiple debug objects, the rocks for example, and I used this little, I don't know, just some type of stone shape for the floor there. It's just a base game debug object. You can find it by entering the bb.showlif edit objects cheat. I then added a couple of columns, some trellis that I created by using a base game fence, and just some little details. I always love to work on the exterior, and it's super difficult for me to just tone it down and to build something that's so small. I created a round shape on the left side where I built the stairs by using a jungle adventure debug object, and if I had the opportunity to, I would have definitely used a round foundation to create this round shape, but I couldn't because of the tile limit for the tiny tier. But I just made it work by using another object, and then on the outside I just used the Get Famous Pristine pedestal to create another round shape. This wasn't really about round shapes for me. You guys know that I have a focus on round shapes a lot of the time, but here I just started to build and I just added more stuff, and then it just happened. I didn't really intend to use round shapes actually. And this is the interior. So I used a trick that I've seen on Twitter a lot during the last couple of days. People really like to use a desk and they move the desk into the bed, and this way the desk it's functional and the bed is also functional. It kind of looks like as if the legs of the sim are underneath the desk. It's not really a bad look. It looks quite lovely actually, and you can save a lot of space. You could probably push it even more inside the bed. What I've learned is you definitely have to use the move objects cheat. You have to press all to move stuff around, and then you really have to just play test this. Like for example, sometimes you only have to move an object a little bit pressing Alt and then it works, or otherwise it's blocking another object. The same goes for the desk that I placed inside the bed, or here I'm working on the tiny bathroom that I just mentioned, some Arky's tiny one tile bathroom, and you really have to just move objects around a lot, and you have to check if they are still functional, and this way you can just create some really tiny homes. I mean, here, these are 15 tiles. This is not micro, it's tiny, but that's about it. This is not really spectacular. As I've said, people are building 2x2 tiny homes, but I just thought that I would just kind of test the water and I would see if I would manage to pull this off. And maybe I'm going micro next time. And I actually got rid of the table eventually because, I mean, the sim can sit on the bed or on the chair, and the sim can eat there, and there's also a table on the outside, so I figured that I don't really have to place a table on the inside. It took up a lot of space, and it blocked the desk and just the fridge, and I don't know, there just wasn't really space for this, so I got rid of it. And this is it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this tiny build. Let me know in the comments down below what you think about this build. And I hope that you have a fantastic day. And I hope I see you in the next video. Bye bye.